Hello friends, my name is B.K. Kollapre. Today we will continue the video on elastic stability of columns and struts. In earlier video, we have seen Euler's theorem for finding out the load carrying capacity of long columns. We have seen the columns with four end conditions and we have seen what is the effective length there. So just repeat what are the different end conditions sequentially and what is the value of the effective length. So we will see first condition is both ends are hinged, L is equal to 2L, with one end fixed, other end free, L is equal to 2L, both ends fixed, L will be equal to L by 2, and one end fixed, other end hinged, L will be equal to L by root 2, L, 2L, L by 2 and L by root 2. And the formula what we are using for Euler's formula is PC is equal to pi squared EI divided by L squared. This is a general formula where L is the effective length, which will be changing in the formula. Now, today we'll see problems on that. Before that, let's say a common sense thing. Suppose it's a rectangle cross section B and D. If I ask you to break this member, so there are two possibilities. Either you'll bend like this in short depth or you'll bend it like this in the long depth. So by common sense, definitely we'll be trying to break the stick in this direction because the depth is less. If I want to use it as a beam, so this is a beam, whether it will be supported like this or it will be supported like this. So the one which is like this will easily break and the one which is like this very difficult to break because depth is more. Always remember the member is strong always in the direction of the depth. In the direction of width it will be weak. Suppose if I use it as a column here, if I press it, definitely it is going to bend in this direction and it will not bend in this direction because B is depth is less in that direction. So wherever depth is less, moment of inertia will be less. So indirectly, the column will be bending in the direction in which moment of inertia is less. So usually we get Ixx and Iyy. You'll have to find out Ixx, Iyy, whichever is the lesser of the two value. In that direction, the column is going to bend. So this is a general idea that I am giving to you. So this will be helpful for us in solving the problem. So let us take a problem here. We have got a long column. If I take a long column, if the length of this column is say 3 meters, L, actual length 3 meters, it is carrying a load of P and P. If the cross section of the column is say 30 mm by 60 mm. It is uniform throughout the length of the column. So here you are required to find out the load carrying capacity of the column for all the conditions. All the four conditions we will try to simplify so that we will be able to remember the formula also. So here first thing what we will do is we know P is given by pi squared E I by L squared. So pi is known to you. Let us take the value of E in the problem given to you is 210 GPa, gigapascal. You need the value in Newton per mm square. Very simple method I have already told you. So if I want to convert this giga Newton GPa into Newton per mm square, just multiply this by 10 raised to 3. This you convert it in Newton per mm square. Just multiply this value by 10 raised to 3 if it is in GPa. So here you know the value of E. So we will find out the value of load here. So we will take the first condition, both ends hinged. With both the ends hinged. So first we want to check in which direction the column is going to fail, whether in X or Y direction. So for that we will find out moment of inertia about xx. So this if I take it as xx and this as yy. So we know for a rectangle moment of inertia is given by b d cube by 12. So here b is 30 and d is 60 cube by 12. So if you simplify this, you get the value as 54 into 10 to the power of 4 mm raised to 4. Likewise, if I take it IYY in this, so here this is a depth and this is the width. So it will be 60 into 30 cube by 12. So it will be 60 into 30 cube divided by 12. Just reverse the values. So this will be equal to 13.5 into 10 to the power of 4 mm raised to 4. So which is the weaker part? IYY. So minimum moment of inertia, which is the lesser of the two, is 13.5 into 10 to the power of 4 mm raised to 4. This is the one what we are going to use in the formula. So if I use both the ends, since we know effective length is equal to the actual length in case of both ends. So what is the length here? This is 3000 mm. Suppose if I use this formula, PC is equal to pi squared into E is 210 into 10 to the power of 3 into I is 13.5 into 10 to the power of 4 pi squared EI divided by L is 3000 square. If you simplify this, you get the value 31087 Newton. So this I can write it as 31087 kilonewton. So this is the load carrying capacity of the column when both the ends are hinged. So first one is 31087. We go for the second condition. What is second condition? One fixed, other free. Second condition, one fixed, other free. The formula remains the same. What will be changing will be L. So we know L is equal to, first is L, second is 2L. So this will be equal to 2 into 3000 is the actual length. So this will be equal to 6000. So what will happen to PC? Pi squared EI divided by, only change that is taking place here is L squared. So L is here 6000 square. If you simplify this, you get the value as 7771 Newton. So this is equal to 7.771 kilonewton. So 7.771 is the second value. We will go for the third condition. First condition is both ends hinged. Second is one fixed, other free. Third condition is both ends are fixed. Third condition is both ends fixed. So L to L, L by 2. Effective length is L by 2. So this is 3000 divided by 2. So this will be equal to 1500. So here in this formula again, pi squared E by L squared. So we have got L is changing here. So the value of L will be 1500 square. If you simplify this, you get the value as 124355 Newton. So this will be equal to 124.36 kilonewton. 124.36 kilonewton. We will go for the last case, fourth case. One end fixed and another end will be hinged. One end fixed and other hinged. So what will be the effective length then? L to L, L by 2, L by root 2. So this will be equal to 3000 divided by root 2. So this value will be equal to 21.32 mm. So again, if I substitute same thing in this formula, I get 21.32 square. If you simplify this, you get the value of 62177 Newton. So this will be equal to 62.177 kilonewton. So we have got all the four values for all the end conditions. You see this third case where both the ends are fixed, that is the strongest column, and the weakest column is second one. Second one is one end is fixed and another is free. It will be bending very easily. So this is the strongest, both ends are fixed, and this is the weakest. One end fixed and other end is free. So these are in between. So one end fixed, another hinged is okay. Then the next one is both the ends are hinged. So this is a typical problem wherein we have seen all the four end condition, only changes in this effective length of the column. We will take up another column, a circular column. Suppose if I take a circular hollow column, let us take. If I take a hollow column, this is the height of the column. So the end conditions we will take is one end is fixed and the other end is hinged. Let the actual length of the column, be 8 meters. Let us take it as a long column. So this will be small L is 8 meters, and the diameter here, are outer diameter is 100 mm, and let us take the inner diameter as 70 mm. Outer is 100, inner is 70 mm. So this is a column. You are required to find out the load carrying capacity of the column. So end condition is one end is fixed, other end is hinged. Now here, this is a hollow circular column, vertical hollow, pipe-like. Now what will be the thickness of this? So outer diameter is 100, inner diameter is 30. So 100 minus 70 is 30. So what will be the thickness here? Half and half. So this is 15 and this is 15. So sometimes you'll be asked to find the thickness also. You find out outer diameter, inner diameter, subtract them, half of that will be the thickness of the pipe or the column. So we know the Euler's load is given by pi squared E I by L squared. Now this is a circular column. Ixx and Iyy will be the same. So here let us find out Ixx is equal to Iyy. For circular section, moment of inertia is given by pi d4 by 64. Here it is a hollow one. So outer diameter is 100 raised to 4 minus inner diameter is 470 raised to 4. So if you simplify this, you get the value of I as 373 into 10 to the power of 4 mm raised to 4. Let us take the modulus of elasticity E is equal to 96 kilonewton per mm square. So in earlier case we had taken GPA, just multiply the value by 10 raised to 3. Here it is 96 kilonewton per mm square. So here also you just multiply 96 into 10 to the power of 3 newton per mm square. So if I substitute the value, P is equal to pi square into 96 into 10 to the power of 3 into I is 373 into 10 to the power of 4 divided by L. Now comes the value of L. Effective span. So this is a third condition. One end fixed, other end hinged. L to L, L by 2. So effective length will be equal to L to L, L by 2 and L by root 2. That is a fourth condition. This is the fourth condition. Both end hinged, one fixed, another free. Both end fixed, one fixed, other end is hinged. So this is a fourth condition. So L to L, L by 2 and L by root 2. So this will be equal to L is here 8000 mm divided by root 2. If you simplify this, you get 5656.85 mm. So if I substitute the value 5656.85 square of this, and if we simplify, you get the value of 110.42 × 10³ newton. So if I convert it in kilonewton, 110.42 × kilonewton. So this is the load carrying capacity of a column. Suppose if I want, see, when we apply this load, it is going to fail. If I don't want to allow that much load, if I allow a workable load, so workable load, suppose if I give factor of safety is equal to 3, factor of safety is equal to 3, then we can find out safe load. Safe load is nothing but the critical load or the crippling load divided by factor of safety. So this will be equal to 110.42 divided by factor of safety I given is 3. So this is equal to 27.61 kilonewton. So this we call it as the safe load, what we can allow on the column if it has not to fail. So these are the two problems which we have seen. Some more problems we will see in the next video. So please subscribe the channel for more videos. Press the bell icon for notifications. Comment the questions in the comment section. Thank you.